Good morning, class 11th. How are we all doing today? Well, it's a new day and we have already begun with the Portrait of a Lady. And as I have divided the chapter into three sections, the first two sections we have covered. And today I plan to begin with you the last and third section of the chapter that I had segregated it into. So before I go further, let us just revise what we did in the previous two sessions. So we already know that this story is not just an ordinary story, but it's the autobiographical account of the great Indian author Khushwant Singh, and it highlights the relationship that he has had with his grandmother. So there is a shift, you know, that the story moves in certain phases. So the first phase is the strong, a constant bond of Khushwant Singh with his grandmother in the village. Okay, now that's a very strong bond there. As we proceeded further, the second phase comes, the relationship that sort of starts getting a bit distant when they move to the city. Now what happens there is that he's no more walking to the school. He is going to an English medium school. His grandmother is not going along with him. They are teaching Western sciences, which of course are not liked by the grandmother. And she is really annoyed when she comes to know that they are teaching music to Khushwant Singh in the school. So basically, music as a subject. But to the grandmother, as I had explained, it had lewd associations. She thought that music was the monopoly of harlots and beggars, and it was not meant for the gentlefolk. But even when she was just not happy with this, she does not express, her disagreement on that, and she just gets quiet, which is very, very evident of the fact that she is not happy with the idea of what they are teaching in the English medium school, because she thought that if they are not teaching about God, if they are not teaching about scriptures, then what kind of teaching is taking place in the school? So basically, she is just not happy. So we know that initially she had started waking him up in the mornings and got him ready to school. But then later on, when he came back, there were no common grounds of discussion. And gradually, the time that they could spend together was gradually, you know, kind of squeezing in. And then what happens? The school is over. And he goes to university. Now, the moment he goes to university, the common link of friendship that they had, which was sharing one room, that is snapped. Which means that they do not have one room now, as Khushwant Singh gets his own room. But even then, the grandmother does not say anything. And the book very clearly says here on page number 5 that she accepted her seclusion with resignation. Which means she accepted whatever it was and she did not, you know, create a chaos about it. Then we come to know that her entire routine, that entire schedule of the day, wherein a major part of the day from sunrise to sunset, she was next to the spinning wheel and she was, you know, reading, reciting her inaudible prayers on the beads of rosary. And there was a special half an hour, and that was when she used to feed the sparrows. Now see, there is a change. When she was in the village, she had village dogs to feed. But of course, this is a city. Here there are no dogs. So she has taken to feeding sparrows. And there were like hundreds of sparrows who used to come to the veranda every day. And some used to, you know, perch on her shoulders. Some used to sit on the head, some on the lap. And she never shooed them away. Kabhi bhi unhone unko bhagaya nahi. But what did she do? She used to, you know, break the bread into small crumbs and she used to feed them. And this, Khushwant Singh says, was the happiest half an hour for her during the entire day. Then college gets over and Khushwant Singh decides to go to abroad. And he thought that, you know, maybe this is going to be a very emotional moment because grandmother was old, and the book clearly says that at her age, it was very difficult to say that how many more years is she going to live. But in the case of Khushwant Singh's grandmother, she was very sure that even if Khushwant Singh was going for 5 years for higher studies to abroad, she was sure that when he's going to come back, I will see my grandson. So as the lady she was, When she went to see him off at the railway station, there was no emotional drama and there was no crying, nothing. But she just, you know, her lips were still moving in an inaudible prayer, and she clasped him in her arms. And the only thing apparently she did was she just kissed him here on the forehead. And the book clearly says that Khushwant Singh cherished the moist imprints, and he thought that this was maybe the last physical contact that he was going to have with his grandmother. But it did not happen so, because come later 5 years again, when he comes back, Khushwant Singh's grandmother is right there at the railway station to receive him. She hugs him, and even on that particular day, when the grandson is coming back after 5 years, her happiest hour is still not with him. But now, even now, after 5 years, bhai 5 saal baad grandson aaya hai, to unke liye tab bhi happiest half an hour nahi, in fact more, was the one that she had spent feeding the sparrows. And Khushwant Singh says that now this time of feeding the sparrows had gone longer. Initially it was just half an hour, but now it had gone to even more. So this is what that has happened so far in the chapter, The Portrait of a Lady. And we know that there have been shifts, there have been phases, and these phases you need to know very well as you are understanding the story. So to go further from what happens next, and today is going to be the last phase of this story. So come along, take a pencil in hand and join me as I give you a detailed explanation of the remaining part of the autobiographical account of Khushwant Singh's grandmother, The Portrait of a Lady.